Welcome to the research study where ChatGPT is definitely used. We are Group 2 A of BSN 3A presenting to you our research study on the purposes, benefits, and challenges in the use of chatbots in nursing education among nursing students. I am Stefano Seku, and with me is Stephanie Louise Gregas, John Joseph Jalandoni, Jenn Jalover, and Kenna Patricia Katalbas. So the reason why we did the study, or the purpose, is to determine, well, the purposes, benefits, and challenges in the use of chatbots in nursing education among nursing students. Specifically, well, we sought to confirm or deny similar prior studies on chatbots in nursing education, as prior studies were mainly speculative at best with regards to, well, the purposes, benefits, and challenges of using chatbots in nursing education.
Now let's move on to methods. Research design. This study used a quantitative research design in a descriptive approach utilizing a survey method to assess the uses of chatbots in nursing education amongst undergraduate nursing students. Now, participants or sample. The participants were chosen through stratified random sampling with systematic sampling per subgroup. Now lastly, instrument. The researchers used a researcher-made questionnaire that was designed to address the unique research, objectives, and hypothesis of this particular study. The instrument was divided into three sections, each of which included questions to assist researchers in replicating the study and understanding the reliability and legitimacy of the data.
Now, on to our results. For our demographic profile, the age of the participants are mainly 21 and above. For sex, less than 3/4 were female. For year level, there is an equal distribution, with level 2 being the lowest due to their low population. The majority of the participants are mainly at the socialized category of B and C, while for gadgets used, the most commonly used chatbots are smartphones and laptops. For the commonly used chatbots in both lecture and RLE, ChatGPT followed by Quillbot and Grammarly are the most used. ChatGPT for its versatility and effectiveness, Quillbot for its paraphrasing and summarizing specific texts, and Grammarly for grammar checks and possible improvement on grammar in general.
For the purposes of using chatbots in lecture classes, essay writing, clarifications, and pamphlet writing are the top agreed upon statements, with the provision of references being the lowest but still in the agreed mean. On the other hand, in related learning experiences classes, clarification, infographics, and health teaching plans are the top agreed upon statements, with the statements being near disagreement are their use in pastoral care, nursing procedures, and nursing care plans, as these things require more of the nursing student's personal knowledge that cannot be taken from chatbots alone. Overall, it has shown that chatbots are utilized for many different tasks. For the benefits of using chatbots in lecture are easy to understand explanations, factual information, and time management are the top agreed upon statements. However, for critical thinking, it reaches near baseline to disagree, indicating that less than half disagree that it helps critical thinking. For related learning experiences, the results are similar but with a lower mean. Similar to the purposes, less than half disagree against pastoral care. So is the critical thinking skills and drug studies. This indicates that although the major half have noted the usefulness in related learning experiences, the minor half do not. For the challenges of using chatbots in both lecture and related learning experiences classes, the majority agree that it hinders interpersonal skills and provide misinformation. However, in terms of dependencies on them for tasks, the majority disagree. This implies that to the nursing students, chatbots have not had a negative effect on them.
For the conclusion, nursing students show little variation in chatbot use across different demographics. ChatGPT is the most commonly used chatbot, followed by Grammarly and Quillbot, mainly for grammar checks and plagiarism prevention. There is no significant difference in chatbot usage among students of different socialized tuition categories. Nursing students find chatbots beneficial for saving time, improving quality of work, and preventing burnout, though their impact on performance remains uncertain. Integrating chatbots offers advantages, like immediate feedback and support, but also has a risk of over-reliance. Potential issues with chatbots include incorrect information, communication barriers, and privacy concerns.
Moving on to recommendations. So based on the findings and conclusions of the study, the following recommendations are proposed for the involved stakeholders. For Commission on Higher Education, also known as CHED, explore chatbots' potential in nursing education and recommend guided chatbot use. For clinical instructors, encourage advanced use of chatbots alongside traditional methods. Also, to utilize chatbots to enhance teaching. For nursing informatics, integrate chatbots into the curriculum and educate on the critical use of chatbots. For College of Nursing Officers, enhance leadership skills through workshops and integrate chatbots into learning management systems. For nursing students, verify chatbot information and balance the use of chatbots with traditional methods. For research recommendations, conduct qualitative studies in chatbots' impact and compare chatbots' effects on GPA and critical thinking. And lastly, for overall recommendations, proper education and guidance on chatbot use, highlighting benefits and ensuring verified information are essential. Thank you all for listening. As we continue to explore innovative approaches in education, let us remember the words of Alvin Toffler. The illiterate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. Embracing new technologies like chatbots can significantly enhance our ability to adapt and thrive in the ever-evolving landscape of nursing education.
If you wish to view our study, here is a QR code in which you can scan. Thank you all so much for listening.